So ladies and gentlemen, this is the last but not least today. Some of our really very special people. We're thrilled to be with us today, thrilled to be part of the experience. Please welcome Helen Bonham Carter and Tom Thumb. And Tom Thumb, please. Thank you. So, let's start with some questions, please. Raise your hand, still take questions. I know. Well, there's a lot of you on here. Right here.
Yeah. This question is for Hannah. You're known for your fashions, and your character is just fabulously dressed. I was curious if you had any say in what your character was wearing.
Oh, I had a big say. But I can't remember exactly where it came from, but I wanted to be attractive. I knew that the part originally wasn't in the first time I knew it. I knew that somehow I had to be, have some revision memory because she wasn't in very much. So, and then at the end of the day, I just kind of wanted to have fun with it and kind of try and be attractive and disgusting at the same time. And then my teeth. I miss my teeth actually. I had teeth. There are lots of things I wanted to do. And lots of bad hair mainly because then people would have to come and touch me up all the time because it was absolutely no information to have my hair did. But no, the origin. It was really fun doing it with her, but I definitely it was a collaboration.
Thank you. Next question, please. Let's go ahead. Get a microphone.
Helen, have you had a chance to ride the skating rink yet?
The only thing is that I can explain why I enjoy playing it and the way I just wanted to have a license to be completely anarchic and naughty. And I know that kids love a license to be naughty. I thought I had to be scary, but at the same time I wanted to be make them laugh too. Be someone that they kind of wanted to be at the same time. So a lot of it was an ambivalence, but in the end of the day, I just sort of regressed to my natural, not that I'm saying this, but I'm definitely, I mean, I'm very good at being, young.
Tom, I have a question for you. We're so honored and thrilled that you kind of put us on the ground here from the start. We got to visit this one of the pods in 2010.
Yeah.
We're so happy that you're here seeing this. Talk a little bit, please, about what that's like to see the start and then to see this part.
Bizarre. Yeah, I actually came to Island Adventures three or four times before they launched the Harry Potter Kingdom. So I was a huge fan from the get-go. Part of my bucket list was ticked off when I had our own Lego characters created, but my ultimate fantasy was to be part of the theme park, and I feel like we're not only part of it, but now we seem to have the majority share of this state. So yeah, it's thrilling. I can't wait to hopefully in years to come bring my family here and see what my little ones think of my life.
Is there a little walk around out there that was special for you that we'll kind of remember for a while? What did you see that sort of will be the brain for a long time?
I mean, seeing the sets in such complete fashion is wonderful. Even this is such a fantastic set. It blows me away, the attention to detail and how long it must take to do it. My memories always come from other people, seeing the wonderful group of kids going around today and seeing their enthusiasm for all the different bits and pieces. Plus, they're usually being a highlight of their experience. And we had some chocolate chili ice cream earlier, which was a lot of fun as well. I've been here for 6 or 7 hours wandering around. only scratch the surface. So it's a great class enough to explore.
Thank you. Other questions? Yes, of course.
Can I ask Helen, please? You had your family with you here last night. What did the children
do?
I can't actually hear.
So the question was, she asked her, had your family with you here last night? What did your children do?
They are, well, Nell is six, so she just started the novel. So, and she's gotten quite far than she is number six. So, and Billy is 10. And they're enchanted. I mean, they're a bit like, because they're a bit jet lagged, to be honest. But they loved the ride, but they went on the ride, but they've only got a ride without me. And then we got on, and then something else happened. But they loved the ride. They really loved the ride. So sweet to see everything from their point of view, as you said. It's like what Tom is saying, is that you see it through other people's eyes. So for them, you know, he's all real, you know. And so, unfortunately, he's really horrible because he's very good. He's so good. Luckily, they realize that he's just pretending to be this, you know, sadistic bellatrix. But they are they're completely enchanted, but they're also great about this place. It makes me a child too. So it really has created, I'm not just for the selling of it, but it really has created an actual sense of wonder and real wonder and enchantment. It's transporting. But you see the kids, I think they're more naturally in that state anyway. It doesn't take much for them to be transported because their imagination is so much more maybe on somewhere else. We tend to close down, well, some of us do. We're paid to be back. You know, actors and mentors, we're just paid to imagine. But what's so great about it, it's better than what we had to act in. Because we didn't have secrets. Look at that secret. We didn't have secrets. You sort of would stop at about 10 feet. And then there's some secrets, we just didn't have anything. We just said, green. Just green, green. And that was it. And then we were just told, well, there's a. I did one, what was that thing? Find it enjoyable to talk to someone. And course you have to make someone, it is a challenge in the sense that you need to have anyone who obeys somebody. You have to have compassion for them, and hopefully you have to elicit some kind of compassion in the audience. So, yeah, any time you want to have, you want to bring, it's our job to bring complexity to a part and make people look as bring as much colour and emotional colour and moral greatness. That's
How about fire? Talk about thank you so much for doing this.